traps? Pick. Nice. Okay, plastic explosives, plasma grenades, and pulse grenades. Hopefully they don't realize we take this stuff and attack us. Shotgun shells, like a combat shotgun. Water chip, ironically enough. Combat armor. We found combat armor. Flamethrower fuel. High-tech armor made out of advanced defensive polymers. Weighing 20 pounds. Twice as much as the regular leather armor Mark II. So armor class is 32. We got 3 and 1, so we just take a look. Oh, it's the same. Okay. Same armor class, but we've got 5 normal, 8 laser, 4, 4, and 6. Now with these second numbers here, the percentage. Well, the percentage goes up too. 25, 20, 25, 10, 40, 60, 30, 50, 40. Nice. And I think I look snazzier as well. Awesome. It's all locked. I don't think these lockers are going to be trapped? Who would trap a locker, right? What? We got it? You gained 4,000 experience points for getting the Gek. Are you freaking serious? The Garden of Eden Creation Kit. This unit is standard equipment for all Vault-Tec vaults. A Gek is the resource for rebuilding civilization after the bomb. Just add water and stir. What the hell can you... How can you add water and make a city? We've got to be close to our limit with the... You know, get some more, though. A Gek! I can't believe we just found it. Of course, now we're going to have trouble getting out of here, aren't we? Yeah. I'm just thinking, guys. Oh, that one's empty. I'm just gonna... So it looks glaring at you. I'm gonna give someone the Mark II. Oh, is this a super stim pack, doctor's bag, 4 stim packs, and a first aid kit. And a partridge in a pear tree. Was another locker next to that one. Yeah, I mean, if they attack us, you know, we'll just do our best to get the hell out of here. Without reloading, because we found the Gek. I think there's a definite chance that we will be attacked. So, in the original Vault 13, if you go back in, I saw it in a playthrough I watched after I played through the game myself. If you go back in and take all the water, they attack you because you've taken all their water and they have no water chips. So you basically doomed them. So the entire place attacks you. So it's definitely the potential for the entire Vault attacking us, which consists of death claws at this point. So, yeah, we'll find out what happens shortly. And I hope not. Ooh, navcom parts. I think we can use this in the I want to call it the Exxon Valdez, but it's the Valdez. I think we can use that there. Cool. So we'll head back to San Fran. These are computer parts that look like they slot into the interior of a machine. The fact that they say Poseidon Oil and Navigational Computer on them lead you to believe they will fit into a Poseidon Oil Navigational Computer. All right. Gonna give it, actually. Can he carry? It's 10 pounds. Yes, he can. He's wearing leather, regular leather armor. So I'm gonna give him this leather armor mark 2. And then have him switch to it. There we go. Because he does get banged up pretty easily. Our friend Lenny. So how are we doing as far as... I'm not trying to look at the locker. He is completely fine. Vic is fine as well. And the other two are somewhere. Oh, hello there. A young woman in metal armor. Well, I'll be. How are you doing, Andrea King? I hope everything worked out for you at the squat. Dahlia. Is she one of the people at the squat? Thanks to you, things worked out great. Hey, I'm glad to hear that. It was my pleasure to do what I could for you. So, what can I help you with? I have some questions for you. What do you want to know? Are you a prisoner here? No, I'm not. I'm here of my own free will, and I like it. I think this will be a safe place for me to stay for a while. I don't have a clear memory of who Dahlia is, but I guess she was one of the people at the squat? Vault 15? I mean, it wasn't that long ago. We were there, though. Alright. Can you leave anytime you want? Yeah, I've been told I'm free to go or stay. I'm staying for now. What can you tell me about the Death Claws? I don't know any more about them than you do, I guess. I'm still trying to get used to them talking to me instead of tearing my head off and using it for a golf ball. It's scary, you know? Yeah, it is. In a lot of ways. How did you come to be here? After I left the squad, I didn't know what to do with myself. I figured I'd just drift into another town and another hired gun job. So I was wandering the desert trying to decide exactly where I should go. Well, one day I was looking for a good place to camp. It was getting late, and I didn't want to be out in the open after dark. Off in the distance a ways, I thought I saw a campfire, so I decided to see who was there. So I sneak up on this campsite, and there are these two Deathclaws sitting around the fire just chatting away. Idiot that I am, I let out a little cry of surprise, jumped up, and turned to run right into the arms of another Deathclaw standing right behind me. Anyway, I just wanted to stop that from scrolling again. Anyway, to make a long story short, it took a while for me to realize that I wasn't about to be put on a spit and barbecued. Instead, I was brought here and interviewed by Gruthar. Now I can live here if I want. And I guess you do want. That's interesting. Why you worry about needing a place of safety? When I let you buy me in the squad, I broke my contract with my employer. I was sure that I'd be hunted down and killed because of it. Seeing you here convinces me that I don't have to worry about that. I can only assume that my previous employer is no longer in any condition to be concerned with me or my whereabouts. Oh, yeah, the guy we killed at the end, Vault 15. You're safe now, Dahlia. You'll have no need to worry about any retribution. Thanks, Andrea King. That takes a load off my mind. You're welcome. I'll talk at you later. Ooh, That's interesting. Is that a robed mutant? Looks like a robe. There's a little girl there. A small girl wearing a yellow dress. Shut up, Maven. I guess sciencing these does no good. These for whatever random reason. He's got it. Alright. Robed, large robed figure.
Hello, I'm Goris. I don't recognize you. Are you new here?
Yeah, it's a Deathclaw. Not a mutant. Deathclaw the robe. Yeah, hello, Goris. Grothar said I should look you up. He seems to think you're the man with the answers.
So you've talked with Grothar. He has a rather inflated opinion of me. I don't really know half as much as he thinks I do. Anyway, so you're an outsider. I've seen a few like you. Some are staring here in the vault. But you look different. You appear to be more seasoned, if you know what I mean. I'll bet you've been around a bit and accomplished things. Am I right?
Yes, I've had some adventures. Say, if you wouldn't mind answering some questions for me, I could tell you some of my adventures in return.
It's a deal. I would love to hear anything you can tell me. What would you like to know?
Is he a Deathclaw? He might be a mutant, at which point... I'm using the wrong voice, but I'll just continue on as if thinking he's a Deathclaw. What are you doing here?
I'm surprised Grothar didn't tell you about me. Oh well. I'm a student of sorts. I'm trying to learn as much as I can about the world and the different cultures that have developed. Right now I'm studying the culture the Deathclaws are forming and comparing it to human development along similar lines.
I think he's a mutant. I don't have a voice for mutants. This was kind of just a, you know, spontaneous thing. So I'll continue a regular voice, I guess. Besides, it's going to kill my voice after a while. I've acquired just about all the information I need here. It would help my research a great deal if I could do some traveling. However, I don't want to go it alone, if you know what I mean. So you're a scholar. That's quite an accomplishment in today's world. Are you a prisoner here? No, I can leave at any time. I leave anytime I like. I haven't done so because I don't want to travel alone. I'm pretty tough and can take care of myself, but I would still be one person alone in the desert if anything happened. I don't like traveling alone either, so I can't blame you. How long have you been here? A few months, actually. I came here from the coast a while back. Wow, you're... Can't tell me more. He doesn't want us to ask that, huh? Well, you're pretty new here yourself. If you don't mind, I need to know more. That's another way. I thought he was going to tell me more, but I'm back to this menu. What can you tell me about the Deathclaws here? They aren't your average Deathclaws, as I'm sure you noticed. They've had their intelligence enhanced by some means not understood by them. It was done by a group of humans known as the Enclave. Really? It seems this Enclave needed an army, and they chose Deathclaws because of their ferocity, physical prowess, and, well, you get the picture. Anyway, the only thing lacking in Deathclaws was their intelligence. They needed to be smart enough to understand complex commands, but not so smart that they'd be a threat to those in charge. So the Enclave started messing with a virus, or some such thing, and injected the Deathclaws with it. This virus was known to mutate humans into some sort of super beings, so the Enclave wanted to see what it would do to Deathclaws. Well, the result was a breed of Deathclaws so smart that they could see that they were destined for slavery, so they played dumb until they could gain their freedom. And here they are. Biggest crock of shit I've ever... that's incredible. You seem very knowledgeable. Can I ask you more? People have looked outside the vault. Grithar. They think they're a threat. The Enclave. The virus. Okay. I wonder if they gave him the FEV, Forced Evolutionary Virus. I hope I get to ask him all these questions. Do you know what happened to the people that used to live here in the vault? They were captured by the Enclave. Guthar and the Pack were forced to aid in their capture. They had no choice, since they were slaves at the time. The fate of the humans has weighed heavily on Guthar's mind. He's never really forgiven himself for his complicity in the affair. The humans were taken alive, but who knows what has happened to them since. Sometimes we're forced into doing distasteful things by situations outside of our control. Guthar should learn to forgive himself. What can you tell me about Guthar? Guthar is not the monster that he appears to be. He genuinely cares about all of us here and is doing everything he can to ensure our safety and survival. All of us trust him with our lives. I don't know what else I can say about him. You would have to get to know him and judge him for yourself. No redeeming qualities. I'll not make any snap decisions about him. He deserves better. Do you think the Deathclaws are a threat to humans? Well, the potential is there, especially when you take their new intelligence into account. However, I don't think that Grithar and his pack pose a threat. They all seem to respect life and personal freedom above all else. Now, I don't expect you to take my word on this. I would ask you to judge for yourself. There are others who live here whom you can ask your questions. These renegade options, quote-unquote. Thanks for the advice. I will ask around. Ooh, this person can join. Do you have any information on the Enclave you spoke of? No, only what I've told you. Wait, there is one other thing. The Enclave showed an interest in some ruins to the west of here. Why, I don't know. That's about it. West of here. That's the Mariposa base, isn't it? The Mariposa military base. Where the mutants were and the forced evolutionary virus was... Yeah, you got dipped in the sludge and stuff. Yep. And we made that place go boom. I guess they're looking for some remnants of the virus. Since they used it, I'm thinking, on the Deathclaws... Well, every little bit of information helps, and I thank you for it. What do you know about this virus? I think it's called the FEV virus. The Enclave is, or was, doing extensive research on it. I'm sorry, but I don't know anything more. Alright, they might be trying to find some notes on this virus. If not samples, surviving samples. I was told you were fond of knowledge. You've been more than helpful, Goris. You mentioned you wanted to do some traveling. How about joining me? Andrea King, you've got too many people with you now. I'll wait here until a position opens. Haha. Cool. We can... Yeah. I think he's going. He's good for making... what do you call it? Goris the Scholar. He's good for making stim packs once in a while, but we usually don't have the ingredients we need to, it's the syringes we're missing, you see? He's wielding a claw. Maybe he is a death claw, but yet he's studying the death claws. Maybe it's a different kind of claw? Let's talk to this little girl. We're leaving Myron. Myron's gonna hang out here with the death claws. Oh, I didn't see her. A short, slender woman wearing a blue velvet sundress. How pretty. Hello, I'm Ariel. I don't think you've seen you here before. Who are you? Oh, she's down too. Hello, Ariel. My name is Andrea King. Yes, I'm new here. It's a pleasure to meet you. What can I help you with? I'm sorry to intrude on your solitude, but can you answer some questions? All right. Are you a prisoner here? No, I can leave any time I want. The death claws have made that very clear to me. They don't hold anyone here against their will, as far as I know.
You're lying, bitch.
I see. If you don't mind, I need to ask you about a few more things. Are you treated all right by the death claws? Yes, they provide me with food, water, shelter, and protection. I feel very safe here, and that's more than I could ask for. Would you like to leave? Why are you so sad? How do you come to be? Would you like to leave the vault? I've considered it, but I would have to say no. I feel safer here than anywhere else I've ever lived. I do get lonely for the company of other people like myself, but hopefully others will come to live here in the future and satisfy that need. How did you come to be here at the vault? My husband and I were traveling with a caravan on its way to the new California Republic. We wanted to start a new life for ourselves and our daughter, Sandy. Unfortunately, the caravan was attacked by raiders one night. They were incredibly brutal. They killed everyone. Men, women, and children. Rand, my husband, died trying to defend Sandy and me. We were next to die when a miracle occurred. I guess some Deathclaw showed up. Oh, so that's your kid then. That's Sandy then? I was holding Sandy behind me, trying to keep her from the monster that had shot Rand. He stood next to my husband's body and laughed at me as he aimed his gun at my head. Suddenly, this huge claw came out of the darkness, grabbed him from behind, and... Well, thank goodness that Sandy didn't see what happened next. Anyway, the raiders were being wiped out by this group of death claws. The one that saved Sandy and me stood near us and talked to me. He kept reassuring me that I was safe and that he was sorry that he couldn't have gotten there sooner to help us. Afterwards, the death claws brought us here. What a crock of shit, I'm out of here. Thank goodness that you and your daughter are safe. So tell me, Ariel, why are you so sad? My husband recently died. I miss him, and I'm having problems adjusting, that's all. I've already told you about the raid, that's when it happened. Must be going now. So that must be Sandy. Hello again, how are you? She appears to be sad. 50 hit points. The kid ran away! Get back here. You know, there's one computer working here. Let's take a look at this. If you can do that, please do so. He's not moving. This is why we need to get rid of Myron. He's good for nothing. Let's talk to Sandy. Meow, meow. I'm a cat, and I have special powers that only cats have. What are you? Oh god, that's brutal. That's a little kid. I'm just a normal person who's quite impressed with your special nature. Can you tell me your name? I'm Sandy. I'm not really a cat. I just like to play. Of history. Can I ask you some questions? What do you want to ask me? Are you forced to stay here? Yeah, my mom always tells me where I can and can't go. She tells me where I can play, and when to eat, and when to go to bed, and when to go potty, and when to go to school, and everything. I don't think it's fair that she can do anything she wants, but I've got to do what she says all the time. I see. Do you like it here? I guess. I miss not having other kids to play with, but Mom says that will change someday. She thinks other kids will come to live here. Until they do, I like to play with Valdis. He's funny, and gives me piggyback rides. Mom says I should leave Valdis alone. He's busy and doesn't have time to play, but he always plays with me when I ask him. I just don't tell Mom about it anymore. Valdis. Oh, we haven't run into Valdis yet. Are you safe here? Yeah, Mommy takes care of me and Valdis wouldn't let anyone hurt me. I'm safe here. Good. I'll be leaving then. She has 25 hit points. You see a small girl. Yeah, she appears to be meowing like a cat. She has on a name tag that says Sandy.
Okay.
Yo, Myron. I want Myron to try to science this, since for some reason I can't right now. Is he actually coming over? No. Myron, you suck. He's out in the hall. Let's try it now. Is he going back in? Don't! No! Here he comes. No, Lenny, don't get in his way. Ugh, damn you. Lenny! All that for failing to learn. Now, I need the biggest thing here. Is moving all the stuff around. Because before we get rid of Myron, of course, we're gonna take all this stuff. All the crap he's been collecting all this time. Of course, I can, like, I can overweigh myself. I can just stand here.
So, you finally wise up, beautiful?
Nope. I'm letting you go. Okay, now it's not letting me take anything else. What's this under here? I never noticed that. The screen didn't redraw itself. That's funny. Alright, So I give Lenny a crap ton of stuff, basically. I forgot about that stuff. Too much to carry. See, it's not, now it's not letting us overweigh him. I want to overweigh him. He can just stay where he is and we'll give stuff to our new friend. Okay, so I guess it'll let us overweigh him by a certain amount. I can take a crap load more stuff.
So, you're fine.
So, I'm not gonna miss this from you. This annoyance. Oh, good. He's a pervert.
Yeah, I'm listening.
Put that weapon away.
This weapon? Oh, yeah, I'm listening.
Take off the armor.
Whatever you say, gorgeous.
Oh, God. Okay, so now if we go in here, he doesn't have any of the crap. So I can go trade. Oh, he has a leather armor rack too as well? Huh. Yeah, I'm over right now. Vec. You can carry a little bit. The only bad thing is this is our only other voiced... I mean, besides Sulik, of course, this is our only other voiced companion. And he uses the shotgun shells anyway, doesn't he? Let's see how much he has. See if he can hold all... it's a lot. That is a lot. Let me see. Yeah, he's overweight. I'll have to switch some stuff to, Goric is his name? The bad Goric isn't voiced. So he's a death gloss. Oh, Goris, right.
So...
thank you. Yeah, wait here until I come back.
Excuse me. Wait for you here? Are you kidding? Tell me you're kidding. Oh, are you fucking serious? Whoa, wait. You keep me around? I'll do you a favor. Could be I know one of Mordino's little stashes in Golgotha outside of Reno.
Forget it.
Okay, I'll wait here. Whew.
Okay. I'm looking for a traveling companion. You up for it? Goris hesitates and you get the feeling you are being carefully scrutinized. I would be honored to join you. Goris the Scholar.